Hey guys, I'm going to explain you how you can do parallel parking with 1 minute, within 1 minute. That is what I was showing you when I was giving you demonstration on the site. You have seen that video. What I'm going to do, I'm going to explain you on the page what I have done when I was on the site. So what you need to do when you're doing parallel parking, just try to understand. It will take not more than few minutes. Examiner will bring you anywhere behind any car and he will tell you to pull up on the left. So better to pull up on the left about time and a half length of your car. Like this is one car, better to stop 1.5 length somewhere here. You should have at least 1.5 car length distance in middle. This will make you more easier to when you are pulling up on the next to this car, it will be easy for you. So better to stop so this much gap. Don't go too close. You will struggle otherwise. Then examiner may mention you after pulling over. Examiner say, okay, mate, this is the time to do parallel parking. Or few examiner may mention you do reverse exercise. So what you will do it when you are comfortable. So you need to have a very good look all around. So check from your driving seat, all around, check, start from the left-hand side, have a very good look all around, all blind spots, blind spot of this side as well. When you are make sure there's no one else is coming, you're all right to move forward. So go nice and steady and stop approximately 1.5 meter away from the park car on your left-hand side. No need to park a little bit further. You're all right to park a little bit further if you are parking within two cars, so you can have more room. But examiner will not tell you when there are two parked cars behind, so he will not put you in a danger. So you're doing when there's no one behind. So better to pull up next to that car. So when you're pulling up next to that car, just make sure you are about door length away. For example, his door is open. That can be your reference point. Just pretend his door is open. So this is his door, which is open, for example. And you stop next to it. When you stop next to it, do reverse gear straight away. If you are not doing reverse gear straight away, someone behind will come and stop behind you. Then you may have no room to do so. So better to do reverse gear straight away. As soon as you do reverse gear, your gear lights goes on. So when these lights are on, driver coming behind, they know you're doing something, so they will give you room, so they will stop behind you. Just pretend somebody waiting here now. What you need to do then, you need to do half steering left. This is your steering. This is your steering like in a straight position. So I'm saying half steering left. So half steering left mean bring your steering into this position. Half left into this position. Bring your steering in this position. When you bring steering in this position, your wheel positions will be like this. When your wheel position will like this, obviously when you reverse back, you come in. So when you are coming in, you should have a look all around and keep reversing. When you are coming like 45 angle, stop your car here. Why are you stopping here? Because you are obstructing oncoming traffic, so you need to make sure no one else is coming. So check blind spots again, all blind spots, and look behind as well, because you are reversing back. When you are reversing back, you need to see back window. Don't forget to see back window when you're reversing. Mostly people, they fail because they just keep checking side mirrors. If you keep checking side mirrors, examiner will penalize you not checking behind. So you need to check behind when you're reversing, remember. So when you're on a 45 angle like this, you keep reversing. So keep reversing until you see the side mirror of this car. That's your reference point to stop. So this is a side mirror of this car. This is a side mirror. Yeah, just pretend this is a side mirror. And this is your side mirror. So this is your side mirror. This is the side mirror of this car. So you can see this mirror is aligned. When you see this, these two mirrors are aligned, this mirror and your mirrors are aligned, that is your reference point to steer full lock right. At this place, you will steer full lock right. So steer full lock right, then keep reversing slowly. Your car go 90 degrees. As you see, your car is 90 degrees, stop. Once you stop here, you need to steer back to normal position. You will break this lock. You need to bring back to normal position. When you are in a normal position, you won't be able to see from the here tire and the tarmac of car in front. So when you are in a straight position like 90 degree, your steering is straight. Better to count 4 seconds. I advise my pupil to count 4 seconds. So keep reversing 4 seconds, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and stop. When you're stopping here, you can see tires and the tarmac of car in front. So you may be 1.5 length away from the car in front. The how you do parallel parking. Keep watching this video again and again, and I am 100% sure you will be able to do parallel parking within 1 minute without any mistake. Remember, main point is pull up next to this car and do reverse gear straight away. Don't delay while doing reverse gear. Then when you are reversing, you need to look behind as well. But don't forget to keep checking all blind spots while doing this maneuver. If you see any cars coming, wait for them. Stop your car. Let them go. If they wait. You do. If they go, then you are right to carry on. If you see any pedestrian coming while doing this, wait for pedestrian to go as well. So you're gonna move when there's no one around you. Hopefully you will like the video. Please subscribe the channel so you can see more videos. Thank you very much for watching.